Welcome to Soto Creation, where we make your imagination and mine a reality. I am so excited to have you here today to make this round balloon garland. We are going to use these beautiful colors, and I'll show you how I set it up because I bought this backdrop and I want to test it out. We're starting out inflating all our balloons. We have this beautiful eucalyptus mint color. I'm just going to inflate each one. I'm not going to be as detailed because I went through with my Valentine backdrop explaining this. So if you want to know how I inflate all the balloons and my process behind it, you can watch that video. I'll have it linked down below. We're going to make quads of each of the balloon, and my plan here is to connect four quads of each color because I want to rotate the colors around the circular backdrop. So we're going to work on that. Now this baby shower is so special. This is the part two of my baby shower series that we planned for one of our friends. Last week you saw the floral arrangements that I did for the shower, and today we're just going to focus on the balloons. So I'm putting together the three quads, and I'm going to make two more of these in this color, and then we'll switch to another color. Like I was saying, making this baby shower is so exciting for me because I have known this friend of mine since 2004. It's been so long, and it's just so cool celebrating each process of our lives. And now that she's expecting her first baby, I'm so happy for her and her husband. Here is our third eucalyptus mint color. We are moving on to this bubblegum pink color. This is a very vibrant color, but I like how all the colors end up complementing each other and just makes the backdrop look really beautiful. I'm going to do the same thing I did with the eucalyptus mint for all the colors. You'll see how I put it all together. I forwarded everything so I'm not boring you by just inflating balloons, but I like to for you to know the stories behind some of my decor, because that helps you see how excited and how special some of these are to me. We're switching to a light pink, and as you can see, same method. I'm going to make two of those, and now the white. This process was faster for me for some reason. I don't know how you feel about looking at all these balloons, but personally, just watching the video myself, it just makes my heart so happy looking at these colors. The colors really complement each other. Well, we have the white all done. And now we move on to inflating our 5-inch balloons. So far, we've been inflating only 11-inch balloons in all those colors. So now I'm going to inflate the 5-inch in the same colors. But this time we're making connecting three of the balloons together. That's going to create that organic effect. And here I have all my balloons inflated and ready to set up. The setup won't be as hard, but we have to still put together this metal backdrop. It's a round metal balloon arch kit. It says kit because it comes with other things that I'm not really gonna use, but I'm gonna let you watch me put this backdrop together. And if you have any ideas on an easier way to put it together, I would love to know, but I'll walk you through my method that I put it together. To be fair, I didn't use any manual because when I opened everything out of the box, each of the metal pieces look pretty self-explanatory. They have each piece wrapped up, and my thought was also whether or not that metal, the gold, would peel off or scratch, and I had no issues with that. But of course, so far I've only used this backdrop once, and so put it together once, taken it apart once. I just don't know how long they'll last. I'll link this backdrop below if you're interested. It comes in different sizes. I got the 7-foot one. The metals just click together really easy, self-explanatory. I'm gonna show you how it works. I'm sure some of you have seen this in other things you've put together. So you insert that part, but you have to push that silver knob inside so it'll fit in, and then it pops out where that hole is. So there you go. Not very hard to put together. I'm working on fitting each piece now. And when we get to the very last piece, that's where I had some trouble. So we're just working our way around. It looks like it's expanding, but it slowly comes together on its own. I think I underestimated or overestimated my height when putting this together, but it turned out fine at the end of everything. Here's our last piece, which is has the other footrest, or the other rest of footrest of the garland. We're going to connect. That's all of it. Now it's time for the difficult part, trying to get that to click. That's the very last piece, and my thought is it doesn't matter which part of the garland you're working from. Tell me if I'm wrong, but either way, getting that last piece would always be a challenge. As you can see, I'm trying to use my body weight against the wall to push it for it to fit, and it's still hard to get it in. Mind you, when it was time to take down the garland, I couldn't. My husband had to help me take it apart. So I can't imagine trying to do it on my own if I had to do it at an event. But like you can see, it's not fully in because of the tension it's creating at the bottom. At this point, I decide to put the legs on. The legs just fit in, but they have little knobs that screw on to tighten them up so they don't just fall out of the stand. But the stand worked well. It's a great stand. In the future, I would probably invest in maybe a 6 or a 5 foot stand to give myself more options when it comes to decorating for other events, especially if it's a kid's birthday. They probably would want something a little smaller than this one, but this was great for the shower with pictures and everything. I'm just looking through the bags and I found some knobs, so we'll put that on. This box also contains what do you call the balloon strip that you can use to put a garland together, but I didn't use that. I've never used one before. I wasn't going to try at this point because I already had a plan in mind to set it up. So it's all done. Putting it up looks great. It's not very sturdy, and I eventually end up using those, that right there. You put water in it and you have to take the legs apart, put that first before you put the legs on. So I had to end up, I ended up taking apart the legs with the whole balloon garland setup and putting that in just so it will be secure. We don't want any accidents with the pregnant mama. So here I am starting with that beautiful shade of green. What you do is just fit the balloons onto the backdrop and twist it so that it's secure. Now, if you're like me with a house full of kiddos who love seeing balloons and just bouncing or jumping into them, that would keep it secure where they don't just pop out of the garland. So you slide it in. I'll explain that again as I put the white one in. So I'm pushing it in, and then the very top one, I'm twisting it around to make it secure. I also make sure that I'm pushing it down and alternating the balloon so it fits and I don't have that many spaces. I'm doing the same thing with this bubblegum pink color. This garland turns out so pretty, especially at the end with all the lettering for the baby shower. Now I put the next color. Did you catch it? I'm missing a color. I told you I was going to alternate colors and I was on a roll and forgot my pink, and I had already installed the white with this color I'm moving right now. So I decided to push them forward and insert that light pink right there. It was a thought process, just trying to figure out how I wanted to alternate the colors, and this turned out well. Here I am thinking I'm 7 foot tall, and I got it done. I'm moving that eucalyptus mint color back in, making sure it's nice and snug with the other colors, moving the white back. Sorry you can't see, I switched cameras here and missed setting up and leveling up the camera so it will capture the whole garland. Again, underestimating the height. Do you remember this floral arrangement from our last video? We made that together. So here I am just putting that together on the backdrop. I'm going to use those zip ties and just anchor them to the back of the backdrop. They hold pretty well. At first it seemed unsteady, but they turned out quite nice. There you go. We're going to put the rest of our balloons. I have to put that first just to make sure that I gave it enough space, because it's a fairly large garland. We're coming close to the end of the video. I appreciate all of you so much for watching. I hope you like this video as much as I do. And it's a girl. We had so much fun celebrating her with all the gifts and games. Thank you so much for watching. See you all next time.